Ya Ramadan, ya Shahr al-Huda, ya Shahr al-Nada, ya Shahr al-Barakat, ya شهر الحسنات يا شهر الإحسان يا شهر الهدى يا
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أذكر نفسي وأذكركم بإخلاص النية لله تعالى.
We start with the name of Allah. We praise and thank Allah for the endowments He gave without Allah being obligated to give anything. And we ask Allah to raise the rank of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and protect his nation from what he feared for it. The Sheikh reminds you and himself to have the intention for the sake of Allah.
إن شاء الله اليوم نكمل في تفسير سورة النبأ ووصلنا إلى قوله تعالى إن للمتقين مفازا.
And God willing, we will today continue mentioning the meanings of the chapter النبأ, and we reached the verse that the Sheikh just mentioned for you.
إن للمتقين مفازا معناه فوزا من كل معناه فوزا كبيرا نجاة من كل مكروه وفوزا بكل محبوب.
So in the 31st verse of the chapter, Allah revealed that surely for the pious there is a great victory. That is, there is safety from every disliked matter and winning and acquiring everything that they love.
ثم بين ربنا سبحانه وتعالى هذا الفوز. من هذا الفوز قال حدائق وأعنابا. حدائق معناه بساتين فيها أنواع الشجر المثمر وأعنابا معناه كروما. وهذه الأعناب يعني هي بالاسم مثل أعناب الدنيا لكن من حيث الطعم والرائحة والمنظر فهو أجمل جدا.
And Allah the Exalted revealed in the 32nd verse that which clarifies some of the matters pertaining to that great victory that was mentioned in the previous verse when he mentioned and orchards containing a variety of fruit-bearing trees and grapevines. And these fruits, although they may share their names with fruits of this worldly life, but in appearance and smell and taste, they are much, much better.
وقال ربنا أيضا وكواعب أترابا معناه جواري على سن واحد.
And among the enjoyments in paradise, among what is the victory for the believers, are females of the same age.
وأيضا قال ربنا وكأسا دهاقا. دهاقا معناه كأسا ممتلئا بالشراب. الشراب الهنيء.
And containers that are filled with drink.
وقال ربنا أيضا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا. لا يسمعون فيها قولا باطلا ولا كذبا ولا يكذب بعضهم بعضا.
And in paradise they won't hear any false speech or any lies, nor will any of them belie the other person.
ثم قال ربنا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا. يعني هذا الله سبحانه وتعالى أعطاهم لأهل الجنة وهذا من النعيم لهم عطاء لهم حسابا كثيرا لهم.
And Allah the Exalted bestows this reward upon the people of paradise. Allah the Exalted gives this enjoyment to them.
وهذا الجزاء هو على حسب أعمالهم التي عملوها في الدنيا. أطاعوا ربهم فالله تعالى كافأهم.
And this reward, this great reward, is in accordance with their deeds, based on the deeds they did in this worldly life. So those slaves of Allah, they obeyed their Lord, and thus Allah the Exalted bestowed upon them this reward.
ثم بين ربنا سبحانه وتعالى فقال رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن. يعني هذا مكافأة وجزاء من الله تعالى الذي هو رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما.
And in the following verse 37, Allah revealed that this reward, these endowments for the people of paradise, are from Allah, who is the Lord, the owner of the heavens and the earth and what is in between them.
ثم قال ربنا لا يملكون منه خطابا. معناه لا يملكون الشفاعة من عذابه إلا بإذنه أو لا يقدر أحد على خطابه خوفا منه.
And in this verse as well, Allah revealed that no one will be able to intercede for another except with his permission. Or it means that no one will be able to address Allah on that day because of their great fear of Allah.
نعم. ثم قال ربنا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا. يوم يقوم سيدنا جبريل عليه السلام والملائكة مصطفين. والملائكة صفا أي مصطفين لا يتكلمون أي الخلائق خوفا من الله تعالى إلا من أذن له الرحمن بالكلام أو بالشفاعة وقال صوابا أي قال حقا. يعني لا يؤذن أو لا يؤذن إلا لمن يتكلم بالصواب في أمر الشفاعة.
Allah revealed in the 38th verse that on Judgment Day, Angel Gabriel and the angels will gather in rows, and no one among the creation will be able to speak out of their fear of Allah the Exalted, except whoever Allah the Exalted permits among them to speak in interceding for another. Interceding for those among the believers. Or that they will not be able to speak out of fear for Allah.
إلا من أذن لهم.
Except whoever Allah the Exalted permitted.
ثم قال ربنا ذلك اليوم الحق فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ مَآبًا. ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمُ الْحَقُّ معناه واقع لا بد آت. فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا معناه عمل عملا صالحا، يعني آمن بالله وأطاع ربه، وهذا فيه تهديد ووعيد، وليس معناه أن لهم الخيار أن يفعلوا هذا أو هذا.
And in the 39th verse, Allah revealed about Judgment Day that this day is certain, that is, its happening is confirmed, and that whoever wanted will obey Allah by performing the good deeds. And even though it's mentioned in a way similar to this, it is not an option. Rather, this expression indicates a threat, and a threat that that the person must obey Allah.
ثم قال ربنا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا. إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يعني آتيا. كل آت هو قريب، كل ما هو كل ما أخبر عنه أن ربنا سبحانه وتعالى فهو آت معناه محقق الوقوع.
And in the 40th verse, Allah the Exalted warned the non-believers of a severe torture, a definite, certain torture that will surely occur.
ثم بين ربنا سبحانه وتعالى فقال إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه. ينظر المرء إما الكافر لما جنى في هذه الدنيا، أو المرء المراد به كل إنسان يرى ما قدم في هذه الدنيا.
And Allah revealed in this verse that on that day the blasphemer will see what they have put forth for their afterlife of evil deeds. Or it means that everyone, every person, every human and jinn will see the deeds that they put forward for their hereafter.
ثم قال ربنا في ذلك اليوم الكافر يقول ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا. يا معناه يا ليتني كنت ترابا في الدنيا لم أخلق وأكلف.
And Allah revealed what those blasphemers will say on the day of judgment. They will say, if only I were dirt, meaning that in this worldly life, if they had only been dirt and not been created as accountable creatures.
أو المعنى يا ليتني كنت بهيمة من البهائم، لأنها أيضا تجمع يوم القيامة ويقتص بعضها من بعض ثم تصير كلها ترابا فيتمنى لو كان مثلها.
Or it means that that blasphemer on the day of judgment would wish that he was an unaccountable beast, an unaccountable animal. Because on the day of judgment, those animals will be gathered and done with them that which is a sign of Allah's justice, and then they will be transformed into dirt. And so the blasphemer will wish that that was his state.
بهذا نكون قد أنهينا تفسير سورة النبأ، وإن شاء الله نشرع في تفسير سورة النازعات.
And with that, we will have completed mentioning the interpretation of the chapter An-Naba', and we will move on to mentioning the interpretation of the chapter An-Nazi'at.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wan-Nazi'ati gharqa. Wan-Nashitati nashta. Was-Sabihati sabaha. فالسابقات سبقا فالمدبرات أمرا. الله تعالى أقسم بجماعات من الملائكة.
So after Bismillahi al-Rahman al-Rahim, Allah the Exalted revealed in the first five verses what contains swearing by groups among the angels. Allah the Exalted does the qasam by whatever He willed, and as we mentioned previously, it involves emphasizing a matter to be mentioned later.
والنازعات غرقا على بعض التفاسير أي الملائكة تنزع روح الكافر بقوة.
So in the first verse, this qasam, Allah does the qasam by a group of angels, the angels that take the souls out of the non-Muslims, out of the body of the non-Muslim humans, severely, in a harsh, tough way. And that's according to some scholars of tafsir.
والناشطات نشطا معناه الملائكة تسل روح المؤمن برفق لكن ليس معناه أنه لا يشعر بالألم.
And in the second verse, the qasam is by the group of angels that gently slip the soul of the believer out of his body. But even though they do it in this manner, it does not dictate that it would be painless.
والسابحات سبحا معناه أيضا بجماعات من الملائكة تذهب وتجيء بأمر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in the third verse, Allah made qasam by a group of angels that come and go by the orders of Allah.
فَالسَّابِقَاتِ سَبْقَا. فَالسَّابِقَاتِ سَبْقَا هنا أيضا فيها وصف للملائكة معناه تسبق بأمر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in the fourth verse also, the qasam is made by a group of the angels, angels that quickly go forth to carry out Allah's orders.
فالمدبرات أمرا معناه لها تدبير لبعض الأمور على حسب ما أمرها الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in the fifth verse, Allah swears by a group of angels that have certain management in the creation, a certain created limited management in the creation that they carry out in accordance with what Allah the Exalted ordered.
ثم قال ربنا يوم ترجف الراجفة هي النفخة الأولى ينفخها إسرافيل عليه السلام فتهتز الأرض وتتزلزل ولا تهدأ حتى يقع كل ما عليها من جبل وبناء وشجر.
And in the sixth verse, Allah the Exalted reveals the day of the first sounding, that is when angel Israel blows, Israfil, jazakumullahu khaira, angel Israfil makes the first sounding, and then the earth will shake, and it will shake severely, not settling until nothing on the earth remains standing.
تتبعها الرادفة, تتبعها النفخة الثانية التي ينفخها إسرافيل عليه السلام.
And then in the seventh verse, Allah reveals, and what follows it is the second sounding. The second sounding also made by this angel Israfil.
وبينهما أربعون سنة.
And between the first sounding and the second sounding is 40 years.
الأولى يموت كل من على الأرض والثانية يقومون فيها للحساب.
So with the first sounding, everything on the earth will die, and with the second sounding, those dead creatures will be resurrected for judgment.
ثم قال ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في ذلك اليوم يصف بعض القلوب فقال قلوب يومئذ واجفة معناه مضطربة خائفة وهي قلوب الذين كانوا ينكرون هذا اليوم.
And in the eighth verse, Allah reveals about some hearts of some of the creation on that day, that their hearts that will be fearful, yani the hearts that belied the day of judgment, will be very frightened.
أبصارها خاشعة أبصارها ذليلة منكسرة كل ذلك من الخوف.
In the ninth verse, Allah reveals their gazes will be lowered out of humiliation. Their gazes lowered, humiliated. يعني, and that's because of fear.
يقولون يعني هذه قلوب يومئذ واجفة أبصارها خاشعة هي قلوب من وأبصار من هي قلوب الذين كانوا يقولون في الدنيا يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافرة معناه نحن بعد أن نموت سنعاد إلى الحياة من باب الإنكار أإذا كنا عظاما نخرة وأيضا يعني زادوا في الاستبعاد فقالوا حتى بعد أن بليت عظامنا سنعود إلى الحياة وهذا كله من باب الإنكار.
So Allah the Exalted revealed in these previous two verses about hearts that will be fearful and gazes that will be lowered and humiliated. Whose hearts and gazes are these? Allah revealed in the 10th verse that they are the hearts and gazes of those who said in this worldly life, will we be resurrected after death? Not seeking knowledge, rather they said this out of denial. And in the 11th verse, Allah revealed that those non-believers, they added to their first statement, they increased in their denial and in their consideration of resurrection being far-fetched or impossible, saying, even after our bones had decomposed, we'll be brought back to life.
قالوا تلك إذن كرة خاسرة معناه إذا رجعنا إلى الحياة بعد موتنا للحساب فهي رجعة خاسرة لأننا كنا نكذب بها ولكن هذا يقولونه من باب الاستهزاء وليس من باب القبول.
And so those non-believers will say, as Allah revealed in the 12th verse, that if we come back to life after death, if we come back to life to be judged, then we will be great losers. We will be among the losers because we used to belie it. And they say that mockingly. They say that mocking the day of judgment and resurrection, not that they're actually accepting it.
هم يستبعدون فيقولون نحن سنعود إلى الحياة حتى بعد أن تبلع عظامنا ثم إذا رجعنا إذن ستكون هذه الرجعة هي خسارة لنا لأننا لم نؤمن بيوم الحساب فرد عليهم ربنا فقال فإنما هي زجرة واحدة معناه عندما ينفخ إسرافيل عليه السلام النفخة الثانية ستقومون جميعا بعد أن كنتم أمواتا في بطن الأرض.
So those non-believers, they said, and will we be brought back to life after our bones had decayed, had broken down? And they said this, considering that is far-fetched and impossible. And then they say, and if we're brought back to life after death, then certainly we'll be among the losers. And they say that out of mockery. So Allah the Exalted revealed in the following verse 13, that it is but a single sounding. That is, they will be brought back to life. They will stand from their graves and be judged.
فإنما هي زجرة واحدة فإذا هم بالساهرة فإذا هم بالساهرة معناه على وجه الأرض للحساب على وجه الأرض يقومون للحساب.
And then in the 14th verse, Allah the Exalted revealed, and then upon the second sounding, they will stand from their graves on the earth for judgment.
ثم جاءت الآية هل أتاك حديث موسى هل أتاك يا محمد حديث موسى يعني خبر موسى الذي أرسله الله قبلك وخبر تمرد فرعون معه عليه.
And in the 15th verse, Allah reveals what means that did not the story of Moses reach you? Did not the story of the news of Prophet Moses, who Allah the Exalted sent before Prophet Muhammad, reach Prophet Muhammad? And the story of the great sin of Pharaoh?
وهذا فيه تنبيه وتشريف للمخاطب.
And this includes an alert for the one who is being addressed, and that is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also it contains honoring him.
إذ ناداه ربه بالواد المقدس طوى. الله سبحانه وتعالى أمر سيدنا موسى عليه السلام عندما كان بالوادي المقدس يعني المبارك الذي اسمه طوى.
And in the 16th verse, Allah revealed that He ordered Prophet Moses while Prophet Moses was in a blessed valley that is named Tuwa. This is where Moses was when Allah the Exalted ordered him.
اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى كفر وزاد في الكفر.
When Moses was in that valley, Allah the Exalted ordered him to go to Pharaoh to call him to the truth, because Pharaoh was a tyrannical non-believer.
فَقُلْ هَلْ لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن تَزَكَّى وَأَهْدِيَكَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَتَخْشَى هَلْ لَكَ مَيْلٌ إِلَىٰ قَبُولِ الْحَقِّ وَتَرْكِ الْكُفُرِ وَأَهْدِيَكَ إلى ربك بالدليل والبرهان فتخشى معناه فتخافه.
And Allah ordered Moses to speak to Pharaoh and saying to Pharaoh, are you not inclined to clear yourself of blasphemy and accept the truth and clear yourself of sinning by believing and fearing Allah?
وأمره الله تعالى أن يتكلم معه بكلام لين.
And Allah the Exalted ordered Moses to speak to Pharaoh with gentle speech. And Moses told him that he would guide him to knowing his Lord with proof and evidence so that he would fear him.
فأراه الآية الكبرى. أراه معجزة كبرى وهي انقلاب العصا ثعبانا وأخرج له يده أيضا فإذا هي بيضاء للناظرين بيضاء مضيئة.
And so Moses showed Prophet a great miracle, and this miracle was the transformation of his staff into a real live serpent. And also Prophet Moses showed them another miracle, which was that he showed him his hand that had become an illuminating white.
لكن فرعون رأى هذه المعجزة الكبرى لكنه لم يؤمن فقال ربنا فكذب وعصى كذب الرسول وعصى ربه.
And in the 22nd verse, in the 21st verse, Allah the Exalted revealed about Pharaoh that he did not believe, even though he had seen those prophets, so Allah, those miracles. So Allah the Exalted revealed, so Pharaoh belied Moses and disobeyed his Lord.
ثم أدبر يسعى ثم ذهب يسعى في إيذاء سيدنا موسى عليه السلام يجمع حوله من يؤذي من سيؤذي سيدنا موسى عليه السلام.
And in the 22nd verse, Allah the Exalted revealed that that Pharaoh turned away from Moses and left and endeavored to war with him, to war with Moses, gathering around him those who would harm him.
فكذب وعصى ثم أدبر يسعى فحشر فنادى حشر السحرة والجنود ونادى فيهم فحشر فنادى فقال أنا ربكم الأعلى معناه لا رب فوقي لا رب يأمرني أنا الآمر لا أحد يأمرني أو ينهاني.
And in the 23rd and 24th verses, Allah revealed that Pharaoh gathered the magicians and he gathered the armies. He gathered his armies and he called out to them saying, there is no Lord with authority over me to order me or to forbid me.
فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى عذبه الله تعالى معناه سيعذبه في الآخرة بدخول النار وفي الدنيا عذبه بالغرق أو أن الله تعالى عاقبه عقوبة بسبب أيضا مقالتيه الأولى قال ما علمت لكم من إله غيري أنا لا أعرف لكم إلها غيري وفي الثانية قال أنا ربكم الأعلى هم كانوا يعبدونه ويعبدون أصناما تحته أيضا.
And Allah the Exalted revealed in the 25th verse that Allah will punish him. Allah will punish him in the hereafter by making him enter the hellfire, and that's after what Allah punished him with in this life by making him drown in the sea. And some scholars said that what is meant here is that Allah will punish him for his two sayings, two horrible sayings that he said, which were his first saying when he said, Pharaoh said, I don't know for you a God other than myself. And his second saying, when he said, there is no Lord with authority over me to order or forbid me. So Allah the Exalted will punish him for both of these things he said.
ثم قال ربنا إن في ذلك لعبرة لمن يخشى. يعني إن في ذلك المذكور لعبرة لمن يخشى الله لموعظة كافية لمن يخشى الله.
And in the 26th verse, Allah revealed that surely in what was mentioned, what Allah the Exalted mentioned in these previous verses, there is a reminder and a sufficient exhortation for those who fear Allah.
ثم قال ربنا أأنتم أشد خلقا أم السماء أم السماء بناها أم السماء بناها أأنتم أصعب خلقا أم السماء رفع سمكها فسواها جعلها مرتفعة مسيرة 500 عام فسواها أحكم أحكمها بأن جعلها على ما هي عليه.
And Allah the Exalted revealed in the 27th verse addressing those who denied resurrection that do they see themselves, do you see yourselves as or the sky which Allah created as more difficult of a creation? Of course, Allah the Exalted, nothing is difficult for Allah. And he revealed in the following verse that he is the one, Allah is the one who made the sky very elevated, and its elevation is 500 traveling years, and that its creation is perfected.
فسواها جعلها على ما هي عليه الآن قوية لا شقوق فيها.
So Allah revealed in this verse that he is the one who gave it the attributes that it is upon, made it as it is now, and that it is strong without any cracks.
وأغطش ليلها وأخرج ضحاها معناه أظلم ليلها وأظهر ضوءها أيضا وأبرز ضوء شمسها.
And in the 29th verse, Allah revealed that he is the one who made the skies nights dark, and he is the one that made the light of the sky appear.
وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا بَسَطَهَا وَجَعَلَهَا صَالِحَةً لِلْأَنَامِ لِلسُّكْنَى فِيهَا.
And in the 30th verse, Allah revealed that he is the one that made the earth be spread out and acceptable for living upon.
وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاءَهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا بَيَّنَ أَيْضًا مَا مَعْنَى الدَّحْوِ هُنَا بِأَنْ جَعَلَهَا صَالِحَةً لِلسُّكْنَى وأخرج منها ماءها جعل منها العيون ومرعاها يعني ما يأكله الناس ما يحتاجه الناس من الطعام في الأرض.
And in the 31st verse, Allah revealed, after revealing that he is the one that made the earth spread out and vast, sufficient and acceptable for living upon, that he is the one that made the waters of the earth spring forth and created that on earth which humans use for food and for their needs.
ثم قال ربنا والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم والجبال أرساها ثبتها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم. يعني كل هذا الذي ذكر إنما هو تمتيعا لكم ولأنعامكم.
And in the 32nd and 33rd verses, Allah revealed that He is the one that made the mountains stable, and that all of these matters that were mentioned previously were for the were created for the benefit of humans and for their animals, for their domesticated animals.
فَإِذَا جَاءَتْ الطامة الكبرى معناه إذا جاء يوم القيامة يوم يتذكر الإنسان ما سعى يعني يرى ما فعل وما تكلم وما اعتقد في هذه الدنيا يراه مكتوبا في كتابه.
And in the 34th and 35th verses, Allah revealed that when the day of judgment occurs, the people will see what they said, what they did, and what they believed in this worldly life written in their books.
ويتذكره بعد أن كان نسيه.
And they will remember those matters. They will remember their doings, their deeds in this life after they had forgotten it.
وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَى معناه أُظْهِرَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَى يجاء بعنق من جهنم بجزء من جهنم إلى أرض المحشر.
And in the 36th verse, Allah revealed that and hellfire will be made to see, yani that it will be made apparent for those to see. That is, a portion, a part of hellfire will be brought to the land of resurrection, to the place of resurrection, to the place of gathering.
كل إنسان يراها كل الناس يرونها المؤمن والكافر المؤمن يراها لكن يحمد الله الذي نجاه منها وأما الكافر فيراها ويخاف منها.
So all humanity will see hellfire. They will witness it on the day of judgment. It will be made for all of them to see. As for the Muslim, the believer, they will see the hellfire, but their response will be to thank and praise their Lord. As for the non-believer, they will see hellfire and they will become extremely frightened.
فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى أَمَّا مَنْ كَفَرَ وَزَادَ فِي الْكُفُرِ وَرَغِبَ في الدنيا عن الآخرة فإن مكانه هو جهنم مستقره جهنم.
And in the 37th through 39th verses, Allah revealed that as for those who blasphemed and increased in kufr and preferred the worldly life over working for the hereafter, then surely their final destination, the place where they will remain, is hellfire.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ آمَنَ بِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ آمَنَ بِالْيَوْمِ الَّذِي سَيُحَاسَبُ فِيهِ وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى النَّفْسَ الْأَمَّارَ بِالسُّوءِ مَا أَطَاعَهَا إِنَّمَا أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ أَدَّى الْوَاجِبَاتِ وَاجْتَنَبَ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ هذا مأواه الجنة الفوز بالجنة.
And in the 40th and 41st verses, Allah the Exalted revealed that as for those who believed in the day of judgment and believed in the day of Al-Hisab, when they will be judged and their deeds presented, and obeyed Allah, they prevented themselves from obeying themselves, their own inclinations that push them to be disobedient and do evil things. So the one who instead obeyed Allah and did not obey his own bad inclinations by performing the obligations, fulfilling them, and avoiding the prohibitions, then paradise will be his abode.
ثم جاءت الآية يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها متى وقوعها فيما أنت من ذكراها أي ليس عندك علمها حتى تذكرها لهم إلى ربك منتهاها يعني علمها عند الله Subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And so in the 42nd through 45th verses, Allah reveals first that those non-believers, they will ask, when will it happen? When is its occurrence? They will ask the Prophet, when is the day of judgment? In the 43rd verse, Allah reveals that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not have knowledge of its exact time of happening. In the 44th verse, Allah reveals that rather the knowledge of that Allah is for Allah only. Only Allah the Exalted knows the exact time of the day of judgment. And in the 45th verse, Allah revealed that surely the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clarifies these matters to those who obey Allah, and he frightens them, mentioning that which puts the fear of Allah in their heart to guide them to what is correct.
إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها أي من يخافها يخاف شدائدها.
That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a warner to those who fear the day of judgment. That is, they fear the severity of the situations of the day of judgment.
بمعنى إن إنذارك إنما ينفع من يخافها.
Or it means that the warning of the Messenger of God alayhi salam, it benefits those who fear the day of judgment. That is, the believers.
كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها معناه من شدة الهول من شدة الخوف عندما يرونها كأنهم لم يلبثوا يوما كاملا ما بقوا في هذه الدنيا يوما كاملا معناه مضى عمرهم بسرعة.
And in the final verse 46, Allah reveals that due to the severe horrors, the terrors that those non-believers find on the day of judgment, the great fear that they have of what they are facing, that as if their worldly life wasn't even a day. That is, their worldly life, it is very apparent that it was extremely short.
والله أعلم وأحكم وبارك الله فيكم.
And Allah the Exalted knows best, and may Allah bless you.